Channel Dentistry to the Point. This is a continuation video or a part 2 video on recurrent aphthous stomatitis RAS. In the first part, we have discussed about the introduction, the etiology, predisposing factors, and also the classification. And I have also given short tricks and mnemonics to learn the big etiology and the predisposing factors. So do check that video. I'll give the link in the description box and also pop an I button. And also I request you to watch that video first and then you watch the second part wherein we are going to discuss the clinical features, the histological features, diagnosis and treatment so that you get a better understanding of this part. So let's get started. Starting with the clinical features, as we have already discussed in the classification, chiefly jo hai, it four types mein wo divided hai. तो जो लास्ट था दैट इज एसोसिएटेड विद बेचेट सिंड्रोम दैट इज गोइंग टू बी डेल्ट सेपरेटली इन द बेचेट सिंड्रोम कि क्या होता है कैसे होता है. सो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द थ्री मेन वंस दैट इज योर मेजर माइनर एंड योर हर्पेटिफॉर्म. सो सबके एक एक करके हम क्लिनिकल फीचर्स वी आर गोइंग टू सी. सो स्टार्टिंग विद द क्लिनिकल फीचर्स ऑफ रिकरेंट एप्थस माइनर. नाउ दिस इज द मोस्ट कॉमन फॉर्म ऑफ द डिजीज एंड इट इज बिलीव दैट 20% ऑफ द जनरल पॉपुलेशन इज अफेक्टेड बाय दिस टाइप ऑफ डिजीज इन any point of their life, at one or other point of their life, they're affected by this. And also it is interesting to note that around 55% of the population includes the school students which are found positive for RAS minor. Okay, why? Because it has been already mentioned in the predisposing factors, that is your psychic factors, that is stress, which is a very important predisposing factor. So stress is commonly found in students during the exam time, etc. So that's why it may predispose to RAS in students. Now, since the name only suggests it has recurrent in it, so obviously this disease is going to have recurrent attacks, and this varies from person to person. जो ये recurrent episodes होते हैं, it varies from person to person. Some may have one or two attacks in a year. Some may have one or two attacks in a month. या किसी को constantly हो सकते हैं within month, several times हो सकते हैं in a month. सो इट पर्टिकुलर डिपेंड्स ऑन पेशेंट टू पेशेंट अटैक्स का जो सीन होता है इसका कोई स्पेसिफिक एपिसोड ऑफ अटैक्स नहीं होते. ऑल्सो देयर इज एन अक्रेंस ऑफ वेराइटी ऑफ मैनिफेस्टेशन इन अ डिजीज लाइक दीज मैनिफेस्टेशन कुड बी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लाइक वन और मोर स्मॉल नोड्यूल्स विच मे हैव बर्निंग सेंसेशन और इरिडिमेटस पैच और इडिमा ऑफ द ओरल कैविटी पैरेस्थीसिया स्पेशली ऑफ द टंग. ऑल्सो दे मे इंक्लूड what you say is lymphadenopathy, regional lymphadenopathy can also be there in your oral cavity, or low grade fever can be there, malaise can be there. So these are some manifestations also. So if you have been following my lectures, then we also do a thing that is SAC, SAC in clinical features, where S is the sex, A is the age, and C is the common site. So talking about the sex, the females or the women are more frequently affected than men in all the three types, be it major, minor or herpetiform. Second is the age, so it commonly manifests in 10 to 20 years of age, or you can say after the puberty lasting for 20 years or more than that. And talking about the common sites, so the commonest sites are your buccal and labial mucosa, and the other sites it involves is your soft palate, tongue, pharynx, and all your sulcuses of your buccal and the lingual sulci, and also the all movable mucosas, okay, that are not attached to the periosteum. So these are the common sites. Now we'll see the clinical picture as to how this recurrent aphthous minor looks. So firstly, it develops as a single or multiple superficial erosion that is covered by a gray membrane. Okay, initially ये ऐसा आता है. Then later what you see that there is, now this lesion develops with a center which is necrotic, which is surrounded by regular margins, raised regular margins with an erythematous halo. मतलब आपको बीच में कैसे दिखेगा, एक yellowish discoloration that is your necrotic thing which is present in the middle, and the surrounding is reddish with the regularized or raised margin. Also, they are very painful such that they interfere with your eating habits or your eating and your swallowing and also during your speech. Also, they may vary in sizes from 2 to 3 millimeters to 10 millimeters in diameter. Also, several studies have been done and what is concluded that 90% of the patients who suffer from recurrent aphthous minor, now they have got 6 lesions or 6 ulcers or less than that in a single outbreak. मतलब जब एक बार आउटब्रेक होता है या जब एक बार आते हैं तो वो छह या छह से कम लिजन या अल्सर्स जो आपको देखने को मिलेंगे, सिंगल भी हो सकते हैं, छह या छह से कम ही देखने को मिलते हैं. ऑल्सो दे परसिस्ट फॉर अबाउट 7 to 14 days, that is your 1 week or 2 weeks, and they heal by themselves and they leave a little or no evidence of scarring. That is, they heal without scarring. मतलब कोई निशान नहीं छोड़ जाते, कोई scar mark नहीं छोड़ जाते. Now moving to the clinical features of the second type, that is your recurrent apthem major. So here also the sac thing, that is the sex, age and common thing remains the same. That is, women's or females are more frequently affected than men. The age group being between 10 to 30 years or after the puberty and lasting for 20 years. And the common sites again being your cheeks, tongue, lips, soft palate, etc. Now, since we have already dealt in classification that this is believed as a severe form of the minor one. So obviously the lesions which appear are going to be large, and similarly they are going to be painful and they are going to cause dysphagia, that is difficulty in swallowing, eating or speech. Also, this type of ulcer, yeah, the incidence of these ulcers are more commonly found in the HIV positive patient. Also, patients with severe apthe, although occasionally show similar lesions occurring in the genitals, that is your vagina, penis or even in the rectum areas, which may be associated with rheumatoid arthritis or conjunctivitis. Now, there are three distinguishing points which distinguish this major from the recurrent apthe minor. And what are these? Firstly, that in minor we said that ki 6 ya 6 se kam ulcers hote hai, but here the number of ulcer in the major can be from 1 to 10 in number. Now in the minor one we said that the ulcers they had 2 mm to 10 mm in diameter, but in the major they may exceed, the diameter may exceed beyond 1 cm also sometimes. Also in the minor we said ki they may persist for 7 to 14 days, that is your 1 to 2 weeks, and they heal without scarring. But here in the major, these may persist up to 6 weeks and they heal with scarring. That is, they heal upon scarring, but they leave a scar when they heal. So these are the three distinguishing points between recurrent apthes minor and major. Moving on to the clinical features of the third type, that is your recurrent herpetiform apthe or ulcer. So this is characterized, or the characteristic thing is that it is characterized by the presence of clusters or bunch or multiple small shallow ulcers which could be present on any side of the oral cavity. Now this was first described by Cook, and later Lehner, Brook and Sapp, they did a detailed study on this topic and added information to it. So according to Brook and Sapp, the characteristic clinical features which they lifted, so there are 5 characteristic clinical features according to them related to the herpetiform ulcers. So what are these? Firstly, that numerous small ulcers are present in the intraoral mucosal surfaces. This is the first clinical feature listed by them. Second is that they begin as pinhead sized erosions, and later they enlarge and they coalesce or combine to form one. Third is that they are very painful. The fourth point is that the lesions present are almost continuously for 1 to 3 years with relatively short remissions. And the fifth point they listed was that the patient who have these type of lesions, so for their immediate and temporary relief, 2% tetracycline mouthwashes were used. Now, because these clinical manifestations or clinical features were similar to that of the herpes simplex virus or that type of herpetic lesions, so Sapp and Brook again, they had to rule out this, ki this yes, क्योंकि हम पढ़ते हैं कि herpes, herpetiform lesions है, because resemblance similar है, but कोई viral etiology present नहीं है, to rule out that, they did a number of laboratory tests and experiments, which were, firstly, that when these lesions were cultured, so herpes virus infection was not, herpes virus was not isolated, herpes simplex virus was not isolated from these lesions, okay? Secondly, when they did a microscopic study, so the herpetiform lesions, those had characteristics identical to the recurrent apthes major and minor. So the cytological smears, they failed to reveal the presence of multinucleated epithelial giant cells which are usually present in the herpes simplex infection. Immunofluorescent and serological techniques were also negative to the antibodies for herpes simplex virus. Hence, they concluded that there is no viral etiology which is present in the recurrent herpetiform ulcers. So this was all about the clinical features of the various three, that is a major, minor and herpetiform of recurrent apthous ulcer. Now moving on to the histological features. So apan agar aap dekho apan superficial to deep jayenge. So when you see an ulcer histologically or microscopically upar se niche, that is sabse pehle upar se dekhte ho, so you see a fibrinopurulent ya fir fibrinopurulent membrane that is covering the ulcer. Superficial to deep ja rahe, to sabse pehle aapko ek fibrinopurulent ya fibrinopurulent membrane dikhegi, that is seen covering the ulcer, and occasionally this membrane contains colonies, superficial colonies of microorganisms in it. Okay, then what you see is epithelial proliferation surrounding the margins of the ulcer. Pehle fibrinopurulent membrane dikhi upar se, jo margins hai that is surrounded by your epithelial proliferations, and granulation tissue present at the base of the ulcer. ठीक है, उसके बाद beneath the ulcer what you see is your connective tissue which is filled with your intense inflammatory cell infiltration, that is predominantly your neutrophils and lymphocytes. Okay, so these are present beneath the ulcer. Now it has also have been found in some cases that these apthous ulcers, they begin immediately above the excretory duct of some minor glands, and because of this there is ductal disruption also present. So many studies were done, researches were done, and finally Wood and his associates, they said that there is a characteristic appearance of the nuclei that is found in the epithelial cells. The characteristic nuclear changes that are found in the epithelial cells, that these cells had a very enlarged nucleoli and also a chromatin bar which radiated or extended to the nuclear membrane, and this is a modified form of macrophage which is present, and they called these special cells as Ennetkow cells. Okay, now this is actually not the pathognomic of disease. This Ennetkow cells, these are not a pathognomic, matlab ki sirf isi disease mein present hai, aisa characteristic ya pathognomic feature nahi hai, kyunki ye dusre disease mein bhi present hote hai, jaise your iron deficiency anemia or megaloblastic anemia, or even in children who receive chemotherapy, yeah, sometimes normal people may be. So this is not a characteristic, but jab unhone experiment kiya to jo patients ko jinme RAS tha unme ye presence of cell unko dekhne ko mila, so they said ki ha ye is disease mein bhi, recurrent apthous stomatitis mein bhi milta hai. So this is all about the histological findings of RAS. Talking about the diagnosis and the differential diagnosis, so the diagnosis can be made by taking a careful history of the patient, also by clinical findings, the clinical picture you see. So uske basis pe aap diagnosis ek de sakte ho. And about the differential diagnosis, so obviously this disease can be mistaken for herpetic stomatitis, या इवन समटाइम्स फॉर हर्पेंजीना और इरिदेमा मल्टीफॉर्मे, इवन समटाइम्स पेम्फिगस ऑल्सो. नाउ मूविंग टू द लास्ट पार्ट, दैट इज ट्रीटमेंट. सो सबसे पहले तो ट्रीटमेंट यू हैव दैट रूलिंग आउट और करेक्शन ऑफ द इटियोलॉजिकल एंड द प्रीडिस्पोजिंग फैक्टर्स. सो इटियोलॉजी में जैसे आप बैक्टीरियल इन्फेक्शन देखते हो तो ऑब्वियसली बात है यू प्रोवाइड देम विद एंटीबायोटिक्स ताकि वो ट्रीट हो, तो फिर आपका RAS भी ट्रीट हो. देन इम्यूनोलॉजिकल अबनॉर्मलिटीज है, आयरन, फॉलिक एसिड, B12 डेफिशिएंसीज है, तो इनके सप्लीमेंट्स दे के आप ये कवर करो. देन यू हैव प्रीडिस्पोजिंग फैक्टर्स जिसमें ट्रॉमा होता है, अंडरलाइन एलर्जी होती है. सो एज सून एज यू करेक्ट दीज फैक्टर्स, अल्टीमेटली योर RAS इज क्योर्ड और करेक्टेड और इज ट्रीटेड. ओके, देन अभी हमने हर्पेटिफॉर्म में पढ़ा, दैट इज योर टेट्रासाइक्लिन माउथ वॉश 250 mg/5 ml 4 times a day for 5 to 7 days. You can prescribe this so that उससे भी थोड़ा सा हीलिंग हो. आप कॉर्टिकोस्टेरॉइड्स बता सकते हो, कॉर्टिकोस्टेरॉइड ऑइंटमेंट्स बता सकते हो, या लाइक योर कॉर्टिसोन एसिटेट, हाइड्रोकॉर्टिसोन, तो इससे भी आप ऑइंटमेंट लोकली अप्लाई करो ताकि जो इन्फ्लेमेशन है वो कम हो. देन सर्जिकल प्रोसीजर्स होते हैं, आप लेजर्स के थ्रू करवा सकते हो, कॉटराइजेशन करा सकते हो, और भी बहुत सारी चीज़ें होती है, बहुत सारी ड्रग्स आती है. मतलब बिसाइड्स सो मच अबाउट दिस डिजीज, स्टिल इसका कोई क्योर रेट एज सच इस्टेब्लिश नहीं है, या स्पेसिफिक ट्रीटमेंट या स्पेसिफिक क्योर जो वो है वो इस्टेब्लिश नहीं है. मतलब रिसर्चेस अभी भी चल रही है क्योंकि बहुत सारे जो अल्सर्स होते हैं वो सेल्फ हीलिंग होते हैं, खुद भी हील हो जाते हैं. तो कोई एक स्पेसिफिक ऐसा उन्होंने नहीं बताया है कि हाँ ये लेने से तो बिल्कुल ही सही हो जाएगा. डिफरेंट डिफरेंट है, सीवियरिटी पे डिपेंड करता है, टाइम पीरियड पे डिपेंड करता है, एवरीथिंग. सो यस, द ट्रीटमेंट इज नॉट येट एस्टेब्लिश्ड. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट योर रिकरेंट एब्थस स्टोमेटाइटिस, RAS. And we conclude this lecture here. We have dealt with all the important points regarding this topic. So please watch this part 1 and part 2 video together for the better understanding of this topic. Also, if you understood the topic, then please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Also, hit the little bell so that you're notified every time we upload a video. Thank you so much.